The Harman Kardon Invoke came out in late 2017 as the first Cortana speaker. In late 2018, it's still the only one. HP and Xiaomi announced their own Cortana speakers in 2017, but there hasn't been any news about those for more than a year now. Cortana is in a lot of places like Windows 10 devices, Xbox, Android, and iOS, but those don't really count as standalone smart speakers. So I decided to buy the one and only Cortana speaker myself and see if it's worth buying right now. Before talking about anything else, I have to mention that I really like how the Invoke looks. It's got amazing build quality, which you can get in two colors. This is the graphite version, but you can also get it in pearl silver. It's an all-metal design with a hint of soft rubber material at the top where the touch panel is. The touch panel lights up with a typical Cortana ring, indicating if it's trying to talk to you, listening, or in setup mode. There's also a small LED at the bottom to show if the speaker is connected to Wi-Fi or not. On the back, there's a button for turning the microphone on or off, another one for Bluetooth pairing since this can also be a Bluetooth speaker, a power connector for power, and a micro USB port. One thing to note is that the Invoke was much bigger than I thought when I first opened the box. That's actually turned out to be a good thing because you'll want something solid and sturdy for a smart speaker since it's going to be on the table for a long time. But yeah, overall it's a simple design, but it's built really well and just looks like something for the future, so I dig how it looks. So this is a Cortana speaker, but what does that mean? I made an in-depth video about Microsoft's virtual assistant a few months back, so make sure to go check that out if you need a better prefix for this video. Basically, Cortana came out of the gates in 2014 as a fun, functional virtual assistant that differentiated itself from Siri and Google Assistant. But since its introduction to the tech world, it hasn't improved by much. Voice responses feel pretty repetitive, some features got dumped including package tracking and music identification, and is still only available in 13 countries. Another thing is that Cortana doesn't really communicate well with other devices, so when I say, "Hey Cortana," both my laptop and the Invoke start listening. It's clear that Cortana has fallen behind its competitors and its future is uncertain. If you're looking for the smartest speaker, this isn't going to be it. But look, Cortana and the Invoke can get the basics done, and it does them really well. Since the Cortana app is basically on every platform, including Windows 10 Mobile, setting up the Invoke is super easy and can be done with basically any device with a screen. You just need to connect it to Wi-Fi and sign into your Microsoft account. After that's done, all your connected services and personal interests are synced, and you don't need another device to use Invoke. To summon Cortana, you can tap the touch panel for a second or just say, "Cortana, wake me up at 9 tomorrow."
"Okay, I've turned on your alarm for 9 p.m.
"Cortana, how's the weather today?"
"The forecast in Berkeley shows partly sunny skies with a high of 59 and a low of 37. Right now, it's hazy and 53.
I used to be one of those people who didn't see the point of smart speakers, especially since we could do all this with our phones, but after using the Invoke for 2 months, this speaker has become my legit assistant. It's my regular alarm clock, weather checker, and reminder. And if you've got some Microsoft products like an Xbox, or if you have some compatible smart home products, the Invoke can turn them on and off for you. It's just way more convenient to do simple stuff like this with my voice and to receive info through audio from a nice sounding speaker instead of tapping through my phone multiple times. Speaking of audio, the Invoke sounds awesome, not only as a voice assistant, but also as a music player. This is a full 360-degree speaker with sound coming out in all directions. It sounds fantastic wherever it is, there's a right amount of bass, and volume can get really, really loud. Maybe it's because I have housemates, but I've never put the volume past 50%. Since Cortana has Spotify integration, you can use this thing to play whatever's on Spotify, including your personalized playlist. There isn't too much support for other music services, but remember that this can also be a Bluetooth speaker. You can just play music from your phone, regardless of the music service, and the nice part is that Bluetooth pairing doesn't completely hijack the speaker, since Cortana can still listen to you at the same time. Sometimes when you're telling Cortana which song to play, you need to be really specific or it starts playing something totally random, but I gotta say, the microphone or the microphones are excellent. Like the speaker, the microphones are situated in a 360-degree setup with 7 microphones circling at the top here. These microphones use Harman's Sonic far-field voice recognition technology, which has been amazing at hearing me from across the room. I don't have to yell to get Cortana's attention, I can just speak in a normal tone from anywhere in my room, and it'll still hear me. In fact, it can hear what I'm saying even with the video playing on my monitor. With these microphones, the Invoke can also make calls. However, it can only do this through Skype. If you say Cortana, call mom, it's going to try calling that number through Skype, and the bad part is you need paid Skype minutes to do this. Skype to Skype calls are free, but no one I know uses Skype anymore, so I don't really use this feature. I guess it's still nice to have, but it's sort of useless if you don't have a paid subscription for Skype. So that's basically all there is to the Invoke. Now, is it worth buying? Well, because this thing is built so well and so good at almost everything it's supposed to do, other than Cortana not being the smartest assistant, I think it all comes down to the price tag and which ecosystem you prefer. The Harman Kardon Invoke was originally $199, but now it's only $99 through the Microsoft Store. I actually got mine for only $49 when Microsoft was holding a special sale, and if you can get it at that price, it's a no-brainer. For $99 though, this is a little iffy because competing products like Google Home and Amazon Alexa are really good too at around the same price. If you're a Microsoft fan or simply a Cortana user, I'd say go for it, but only if you have $100 to spare. A smart speaker is nice to have, but not something that anyone needs. For people who don't really care for the ecosystem and just want a good smart speaker, this is a great option. I wouldn't say it's the best one out there, but I think it does hold up against the competitors. Alright, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. And if you want to talk to me more directly, feel free to talk to me on my social. Thanks again, and I'll see you guys on the next one.